that you don't have vegan options in your hospitals or in your prisons, and often in your schools either, how much better would it be if the prisoners were eating foods that weren't built on violence and killing? How much better would it be if in the schools the kids were eating foods that were healthy and gave them energy and life rather than took those things away from them? How much better would it be if we were all eating a plant-based diet? Better for the environment, better for the billions of animals killed every day, and also better for our health. Something like heart disease barely needs to exist. So, Vegan Options Canada is where it's at.
Hello, my name is Alisa, and I co-founded Vegan Options Canada. I did so because I saw that in spite of the growing numbers of vegans, of vegetarians, and even of flexitarians in Canada, there was no or almost no vegan meals readily accessible in most institutions. So I'm talking here about schools, universities, hospitals, daycare, and nursing homes, also prisons. I had to go through those struggles, namely when I was at university or at work, and my partner too had to face similar challenges when he had to go to the hospital, a place where we rarely choose to go. So, a plant-based food option is therefore not only possible, we think that it is, well, necessary and urgent. So statistics show that 10% of the Canadian population is vegetarian and almost 4% is vegan, and that was in 2018. Those numbers are increasing day by day. But yet, no institutions cater to that need. This has to be addressed. We believe in self-reflection, critical thinking, non-violence, and community. If you believe in those principles, the main one being learning, collective learning, non-judgment, and changing the conditions in which we live instead of acting on the people committing violence, I think we need to change the conditions in which this violence occurred.
Change in our economy through the transformation of the food system is not a frivolity or a preference, but rather a current and rational ethical prerogative. Collective well-being must not be built on the suffering of others, whether human or animal. Poverty, inequity, industrial waste and food insecurity exist and must be addressed directly. Pandemics such as COVID-19, natural disasters due to climate change and environmental racism are a direct effect of factory farming. Eating well-balanced plant foods is not a punishment, but a gift, which anyone can decide to take at any time. Let's work towards an inclusive, resilient, and non-violent food system.
Also, the new Canadian Food Guide, as well as the American Dietetic Association, acknowledge that vegan food is suited for all stages of life. also, many people who are concerned about their carbon footprint actually are very interested in vegan diet or vegan meals, just as a way like that, a day-to-day practice to reinforce the protection of the environment and say no to climate change. And also, plant-based meals are not only for vegan. You don't need to be vegan to eat healthy, delicious food. Anyone can eat a scrumptious pad thai, veggie pad thai. Anyone can eat a delicious plant-based burger with very crunchy and delicious fries. It's really for everyone. And it doesn't obligate or push on anyone. We're only asking to have one option more on the menu that will fit all, not only vegans, but just any. So if you believe in the resilient, safe, and sustainable food system for all, please take part of Vegan Option Canada, and we will try to make everything possible.
Showing compassion is not a weakness, it is a strength. Let's always remember that the utopists of yesterday are the realists of tomorrow.